Karen's on the line. How are you, Karen?
Yeah, I'm fine, thank you.
What are you thinking tomorrow night?
Yeah, I think we will do it. I do think we will go top of the league. That's what I was phoning because you were talking earlier about Valentine's.
Oh, yes.
And, well, I'm a Rangers fan. My fiancé is a Celtic fan. And I said to him, I'll make a nice dinner, but then I'm going to watch the football.
Love it.
I see, why not? What are you cooking, Karen?
Sorry?
What are you cooking?
Doing a three-course dinner. Doing prawns, then steak, and then a caramel cheesecake.
By the way, if that was me...
Don't say anything you're going to regret. No, that would be my advice to you.
I would be over the moon with that, and I'd be saying to Karen, enjoy the game as I'm closing the door to sit down, watch a TV with a nice glass of wine after that. Fantastic dinner.
Karen, is your cooking good enough that your fiancé is going to make up for potentially seeing your team go above his in the league?
Oh, yeah.
It's a bit of took a minute, but there is a bit of confidence in there. So you're going off to the game and leaving him on his own.
All I wanted for Valentine's.
So if you lose, no, if Rangers lose the game, is there still a bit of romance when you come back for the game?
Nah.
What if they win?
What she's really saying is there's no dessert.
Karen, I'm worried about this. These two have got that mischievous look in their eye.
All I wanted for Valentine's was Rangers to be top of the league. And then his answer was to me, well, we know what happened a few years ago on Valentine's Day.
Oh, well, yeah, that is very true. See, Aaron's keeping this very much football focused, which I suspect you two are trying not to do.
That's so, why our mics are down.
I think it's in everyone's best interest that we just draw a line under it right now. Wish Karen and her, what's your fiance's name, Karen?
Kevin,
we wish you both the best. Hope you have a successful night, whatever that means for both of you.